Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Bharathi from Somaiya College of Engineering, and I'll be talking with respect to the University of Mumbai. It belongs to, KJ Somaiya College of Engineering belongs to Mumbai University. I'm from Computer Engineering Department, assistant professor there from last 9 years. And I'll be talking about the syllabus, lesson plan, experiment list, university exam papers, and the institute's term test papers. And before actually going to the topic, I like to share my thought. And I'm always a dissatisfied teacher now also, because always when I used to go to the class, since there are a spectrum of students from low grade to average and the experienced one, the more excellent or brilliant student, I was never felt that I'm satisfying the needs of all the students. And I've always worried, what is the solution for this? Can I alone be able to solve this problem? But there was no solution, as I was not having any dream or anything like that. But today, I'm very happy that after 6 months, there will be some solution for this. And I'm a part of the solution. I'm very happy and thankful to Dr. Fatak, sir. The syllabus is actually given by the university, and it is sent to all the colleges. And the class is given, it is for all the branches. That is, number of lectures for first semester is 3, and the second semester is 2. Actually, in the university, we have semester 1 and semester 2, and it is called as CP1 as a computer programming language 1 and computer programming language 2. And in the first semester, we have C and C++, and in the second semester, we have Java. And the first semester, we have only 3 hours given for C and C++. And coming to the evaluation system, we are having 3 examination of 3 hours, 100 marks question, and term mock of 25 marks, then total 125 marks given for the subject. Then coming to the syllabus, we are having 6 modules coming from, we will be starting with the structured programming using C++, and the end we will be having introduction to object-oriented programming. In the beginning, we will be starting with the concepts of structured programming using C++ only, but we will not be using any object-oriented concept like classes and all. So we will be starting with, you can say, the programming, simple programming languages. We start from the fundamentals like character set, identifiers, keywords, data types and everything. And the number of hours is also given by the university, but this number of, this is just the guidelines. Depending on the teacher who is taking the subject, they can change the number of hours when they take actually, or when they plan in the beginning of the semester, that is given in the teaching plan. Then we have data input and output, the control statements, if else, while do, and the loops. Then we have functions and arrays. We have in the end pointers, structures, and unions. And at the end, 2 units are given for object-oriented programming, and again in that, the late binding and the advanced topics of the object-oriented. So totally, we'll be having a 14 weeks of semester of 3 hours per week. So totally, nearly 42 lectures we'll get. And again, we can take 45 lectures, 42 lectures we get, excluding the holidays. And coming to the term work includes 25 marks. And this term work marks is divided into 10 marks for the written test. And in the semester of 14 weeks, there will be 2 tests conducted, one at the mid of the semester and one at the end of the semester of 25 marks each, and that will be at the end converted into 10 marks. And usually in our college, we take the 2 tests and the average, and then we convert that into 10 marks. And the 5 marks is given for the attendance, because this university feels and everybody feels if the students are attending regularly, he has to be rewarded for that, and hence the marks they get also increases. And documentation and assignments. This is respect to the practicals we perform, the students perform, given for 10 marks. And these subjects, CP1, we are having, the university says we are to conduct 20 experiments, from the syllabus, and if required, teachers can give their own assignments. So 20 experiments in the 14 weeks, so we can expect the students to complete minimum 2 experiments in a practical session. And they give textbooks and the references books. This is a university question paper of May 2008, last year's. It is of 100 marks. You can see your first question is made compulsory of 20 marks. Usually the questions, we can expect 7 questions. One is first question, that is of 20 marks. All the questions carries equal marks, but the first question is made compulsory and all other questions carries even the 20 marks. But out of 5, the students can attempt any 3 questions. Usually in the first question, like objective type, 2-3 marks questions are expecting the outputs are from the given program are asked, so that the students can at least score marks in that. And other parts we can expect programming as well as the description. This is from the December 2000 paper.
So what I was saying is, if you turn over the next page, yeah, here also you have this question, explain storage class with one programming example.
Yes, sometimes I think in the university, our Mumbai University, we can expect 60% or 40% of the repeated questions.
Repeated questions?
Yeah. At least 40%, I'd say.
We have been conducting JE for 50 years and we don't repeat a single question.
But it can be like this also, because for the students, the syllabus is vast and they will not be having how much is to study, how much depth we are supposed to study.
This is one of the major worries that almost all educationists in the country have, that if this pattern continues, how do, this is one of the reasons why, because I thought this practice died in 70s when I was a student this used to happen.
Sir.
So in my first year I studied all subjects, all syllabus. In second year I could study only 60% of the syllabus and get 85 marks. Because 6 out of 10 was the standard this thing.
Okay.
And then again I had to study because the questions there in those days were repeated from alternate years in the past. So only in one paper I remember, building materials, there's some crazy paper setter who did not repeat questions from alternate years but repeated a question from the second year prior to this. So I had no clue on that. I still don't know how I passed that subject. But so I had to make up for all that when I came to IIT as a student. I was chewed up completely, you know, I survived just. But anyway, that's a university pattern, so you can't help it. One of the objectives is that when you go back,
sir,
and when this portal and all actually becomes operational, you should then make presentations to your own senate or whatever it is, saying, look, we must at least change this pattern.
But,
because you see, university does not insist that the questions must be repeated.
Right.
University also does not insist that there must be a choice in the question paper. It is the mindset of the paper setters actually.
Yeah, we can think, it is also some reason that since many of the students joined to the engineering, then at least the person who is above the average should pass. And those who are excellent, they will pass with good percentage. Like that, keeping in mind that average students also should not fail. I think this pattern is followed, I feel.
I have a different feeling in a pedagogy. I feel nobody should fail. If anybody fails, as a teacher, I am personally responsible.
Yes, sir.
Because if a student has not failed, it could be for one of the two important reasons. One, the student has not studied. And second, I have not taught well. And as a teacher, I have to assume that all students are studying well. Therefore, if they fail, I am responsible. So, anyway, but that's a pedagogy issue. We will discuss that later.
Okay. And I will show you the test papers which we give in our college. And usually the test is for 25 marks of 1 hour duration. Marks is, okay, this is the style we follow, the department information and the test and the subject. And usually we don't follow any of the guidelines, like the question should be of this marks, that marks, because in this we are having intake of 60 students and there is 5 branches of double intake. So nearly 500 students are entering into the engineering every year in our college. So there are 10 staff members taking the subjects, I mean teaching the theory, and plus 3 more staff members handling the practicals. So nearly I can say 30 to 40 faculty members are involved in teaching as well as in taking the practicals. So we have a group, CP faculties group, and 1 or 2 people from computer one and from IT are made as the coordinators. They discuss about the practical list and the assignments, test paper like that. So this is some exam question papers, first test. And this also mainly depends on how much portion we have covered that. And we make it a point that this much of the portions has to be covered before the first test.
These you call term tests?
Yes, sir, term test.
And you
conduct
only one or
two tests. One in the middle of the semester, I can say after 5 to 8 weeks. No, 5 weeks, 5 to 6 weeks.
The only thing is, if you look at the marks allocated, you have 25 marks two tests,
sir.
But you all convert that into 10 marks only.
Yeah, how we take the average, we club to
correct.
Yeah, average.
But okay, suppose I am a student,
sir.
Then I will say that for all the Godagiri that I do, I will get only 10 marks.
Yes.
Whereas my theory paper marks are what, 100.
Sir.
And 5 marks for attendance and 10 marks for documentation, etc.
Sir.
So, do you believe from your experience that students are really committed to do these term papers and they take it seriously?
Yeah, because during the examination, since so many colleges are involved in the university and will not be knowing how the paper come, and because nowhere it is described paper should come in this pattern. So, everybody is worried to get maximum marks in the term.
In general, sir, what is the pass percentage of students in the university in this subject? Any idea you have? In your own college?
In our own college, it is more than 75 to 85, I feel. Yes, and I feel...
I will repeat, since he did not use the mic. He is saying that there are 48 to 53 colleges in the university, and as per his information, the result typically is in the range of 40 to 50% for this subject.
Okay, we can say in this also, because after the 12th, the students are entering to the engineering stream. In 12th, we can say everything is spoon-fitted and they go to the classes and only the subjects, whatever is given in that, everything is available. But as soon as they enter the engineering stream, it is not like this. The whole studying pattern changes, and there are 6 subjects there to come regularly to the college. In Bombay, we can understand traveling only takes 4 hours, and in other timings, they attend all the lectures. And in a day from 9 to 10 to 5, except 1 hour break, lunch break, they are totally busy. And I think the people are finding it difficult to cope up with the first year in the first semester. Not only for this subject I am telling, for all the subjects.
I think it is this is because I can understand being busy. When we keep our students busy not only for 8 hours but almost for 20 hours.
This is academic, I am just saying.
But the major problem in the town is that the travel time is not just the time, but the energy loss also,
yes,
the
sir,
travel,
yes, sir.
And fatigue that sets in.
Yes.
So when it is a residential campus, it is possible to work for many more hours without losing your energy. Okay.
And we have.
And do you also use the chalk and blackboard kind of thing?
Yes, sir. We have LCD projectors. One LCD projector we have in the department. If you feel, I can take to the classroom, and it is not installed in the classroom.
Yeah, but it is one projector.
Yeah, yeah.
And if you have 600 students,
it is not, that is the problem.
It is.
Yes. But we are having OHP projectors. Many people are using OHPs, and we also use blackboard.
So those who use OHP,
sir,
how do they make slides? Do they write by hand?
Yes, sir. We make
pilot pens or whatever those.
We use all the time. Sometimes when you sit and writing, we write. Otherwise, if I'm actually typing the program on the computer and I'm satisfied with that, also I will take the printout and the transparency.
How do you print? So you have overhead projectors, but you need transparency. You don't have a device like
this. No. Means the transparency should be ready before we go to the class.
Typically, what is the cost of a transparency and transparency printing?
Transparency is 8 rupees outside.
3 rupees per slide. So you give the material, people can give you printed slides for 3 rupees, is it?
Yes, yes. But as I know, it is 5 to 8 rupees some places.
Okay. 5 to 8.
And transparency, yes.
And typically, how many slides a teacher would be using in a lecture?
Minimum
lecture.
10.
10
if it is only problem explanatory, 4 is also enough.
So 10 to 15.
Yeah, so 5 to 15 we can say, depends on what.
So
yes,
if we take average 10,
yes,
and you have 40 hours, right?
In yes, sir, 42.
So about 400 to 500 slides. So at 5 rupees, you are talking about an expenditure of 2500. But there could be multiple classes going on simultaneously.
Yeah, yeah.
So you will require multiple copies.
So what? So what we are doing, since many people's faculty members are involved in this, so when we thought of making the transparencies, we are given assignments like this. I'll prepare this, we'll prepare this, you'll prepare like that. Then we have shared those things. And usually come.
Well, the reason I'm asking this question, I want your opinion on this, is that while we prepare slides either in ODT or PDF or PPT format and include them, it might be worthwhile to design slides for printing onto the plastics, which people can print and use.
And this is the second test paper which covers the other part of the syllabus, which recently, sorry, last semester's. And structures, second part of the syllabus.
Oh, answer the following. You are supposed to write descriptive answers.
Yeah.
What is data abstraction?
This is one liner. Depends on the, to understand their concept.
This is one question I have.
Sir.
Of course, Bombay University, this may not apply because students coming there should be reasonably good in their English expression.
Sir.
But Bombay University will also have affiliated colleges in smaller towns.
Sir.
Now, here is a question that I have. Explain the significance of constructors. You expect me to write in English, whatever, two sentences or three sentences. Are you sure that all your students are capable of expressing themselves in English by constructing the answer, or whether they would have read and mugged it up and they would reproduce it? What is your experience?
My experience, usually students
try to write on their own in their own words.
Okay, because since 12th, after 12th only they come, means 11th and 12th they have studied in English medium only.
Are you sure of that?
Yes, many people.
I am talking about those few who have not studied in English medium.
Till now I have not come across those students.
Maybe
in Bangalore.
Yes.
So it is not about it.
We
generally use that keywords are written. We can understand that a student knows that and we use it up.
Okay.
So it is not about it. It's some of the keywords regarding
the concept.
Meaning you are not worried so much about the syntax of English language.
Yeah,
but as long as the fundamental concept is understood,
sir.
You believe that person is understood, that is okay.
These are the basically, these are the questions in which the students can pass. They will help, these marks will help the student to pass in this subject.
Oh, I see.
But this is only for 5 marks, that's why some percentage.
Specific marking has to be done. Marking has to be done and the student will pass.
Whereas in the programming problem, they have to solve the problem.
Yes. Complete ability is required.
It is very interesting because I find this more difficult than writing programs.
Anyway, the students are coming from 12th, you know, so they are very good in mugging up these things. That way, you know, they find these things very easy.
I agree, but the worry is that what we are trying to ensure is that the students understand and they are able to articulate themselves better.
Yes, sir.
So, mugging is a shortcut that they have figured out to pass the exam. Otherwise, difficult.
Yeah.
But since everything, I mean, the concepts of basic concepts of each, you can see data abstraction, constructors, the basic concepts we are asking. So the students, we as a 11th engineering students, they should know these things. I feel.
No, they should know. There is no doubt.
Yes.
But whether what they are telling you is what they know or what they are telling you is what they are mugged up. That's the question.
The one.
But
one thing to tell. Yeah.
Answer is not out of understanding, their understanding or out of mugging.
And, okay.
We don't know that.
Yes, we don't know, but still, when the staff members, faculty checks the paper, we'll understand whether the concept is clear or not.
It's a mix of both, yes.
Mix of both, we can see.
I can see that you do have fairly good number of programming problems to solve.
Yes, sir.
You also have to write programs.
Yes,
so, this is the university exam or your paper?
This is our institutional paper.
But the solution, you know, is only done by 10% of the students. Rest of them are going to copy this and they have to.
No, but the test will not be
done. Yeah. But in the test you can do that.
No,
you
test
can,
it they
you can
do copy.
That during the lab or something, or assignment or reports.
Yeah,
but when a test is conducted, you can do that.
This is a
test paper.
Test paper.
But I am very happy that 10% people actually do the problems on their own. I thought the ratio was worse than that.
Just added to this thing, what paper you have shown, madam?
Sir.
Actually, what happened since last 2 years, university has, you know, accepted some different practice. Previously, you know, every paper setter has to submit 3 papers, and after that, you know, one has to be picked up from that and to be printed. Now, what happened after that, they started a new practice, like, you know, instead of picking up one complete paper, they are taking two, three questions from different papers. That might be the reason that question is, you know, been repeated.
Okay. That is totally with the university,
that's true.
Not in the faculties. And now, sir.
Just to, because I do take these issues seriously,
sir.
In our joint entrance examination, there are typically two completely independent teams, okay, which are setting up the paper, but they completely take one paper. But each team ensures that there is no question repeated from the previous 40 years of exams. In general, a paper setter would be aware of what questions were asked in the previous years or something. The problem is, when you have to ask theory type of questions, how many distinct theory type of questions can you ask every time? Problems you can give almost infinite number. So that's an issue.
Yes, sir, we follow in our college lesson plan, contents analysis plan, and the one more lecture report format. This is the lesson plan. In the beginning of the semester, since the subjects are allotted, we do like this. It comes with the subject and the division, semester, name of the faculties, number of students, and which branch students will be teaching. And here, since we know how many holidays may come, this is divided according to how many number of lectures I will be getting. So accordingly, we will divide the portion into 1 hour lecture, and according to that, and here I will be giving whether I will be using a blackboard or the OHP like that, and whether this portion is included in the lab assignments, that information, we and what are the books we will be referring. And still, I think in books referred, some more improvement is will be trying to make, what page numbers also from that textbooks we are referred, that we are planning to insert next. And
so,
even
no, it is important, so when we build our own contents, it does not matter what books are followed in IIT or at one particular place, but we should try and encompass all these things, because immediately that is what will be the meaningful to students. Subsequently, let us see how we can evolve it. Okay.
Okay. And now this, I am showing the list of experiments. Okay. Since we are having 20 experiments, compulsory questions, we have to give experiments, and we have made it 6 units are there in the syllabus. According to that, questions are designed here. Six units are there. Then from each module, we are given the questions, and we are making the here we have made an attempt to give the simple programs for practice, like 1 or 2 programs, and other program the student should do. And here sometimes we are given the choice also, any of the four they can do any of the two programs.
In the lab sessions,
sir,
students actually write these programs? Means they write,
we
the
expect
programs?
Actually, we this list is displayed before the students come to the lab. So we expect them to come with some preparations, like some logic or programming.
Then what our friend observed becomes very pertinent.
Yes, sir.
That if you have printed the list, then I will go to Kalpana and say, please show me your program, and I will of course write it in.
Yeah, that. But even after that, we are finding it difficult. People are not coming with the programs. Even displaying this list, they don't come with that much preparation. This is my experience.
Because they have to submit a printout. Generally, in some of the college, you can find out they submit photocopies of the printout. So that it is a printout, the photocopy and the laser printout is the same.
Yes.
So,
it is very interesting. In 1965, this problem had arisen in JSITS Indore. So, in 1959, before I went there in 1964, so 58 or 59. After that, what they started is that journals which are submitted, they used to punch a big hole through and through that journal, so the same journal cannot be submitted.
Yes, yes, we do that
it
now.
It is done even
yes,
now.
Yes.
That is very interesting. Any practice is
good. And the answer to this, even after displaying, as I told, the people will not come with the answers.
So they may not come prepared.
Yes.
But that means they will actually try on their own and they come to the lab.
But that kills the time. Within two hours, they will not be able to do the 4 programs.
So here is a question which we can debate later.
Sir.
Instead of asking them to do 4 programs in a 2-hour lab, would it not be better to ask them to do 2 programs in a better way.
Yeah, this is the what we have done last year.
Okay, okay.
Huh? And this time
this
we have made
it. This is up to you, of course. This is not prescribed by university.
No, 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 no. Okay. But we are following. This is we are done in the last year. But this time we made the other only. We are expected. We are not asking them to do the practice program. We ask them to do at home or come. Then whatever the compulsory programs are, they are supposed to do it. Other things like we have remote center in our college. Yes, sir. Is you said center we have. I am from Somaiya Engineering. Vidya, we are.
Remote center, yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We are banking on that actually.
I don't
but
know.
But is it working all right?
Yeah, yeah. But I think last year we have started with, and only our college people are getting the use of that. Now I think some more publication, I mean, publish as required to take the people for that.
In fact, tomorrow when my colleagues, Rahul and Samir Sastrabuddhi and Arvind Patel,
sir,
discuss the technical issues. Please ask them threadbare, you know, what problems you have, what problems they have or whatever, because that whole thing has to work like a well-oiled machinery, otherwise the whole proposal will collapse.
And we have one seminar hall which is in the same ETCP center where we have. It is of 100 people capacity.
Oh, 500 people?
No, no, 100. 100. And we have 3 servers of 4 GB each. And in practical labs, we have all duo core machines, duo core machines of 1 GB hard disk and 1 GB 512 MB also, then 40 GB hard disk.
The old machines.
Yeah.
And what software environment do you have on each?
That actually depends on the what subjects we are taking in that lab.
No,
but
CP1. For the programming?
Yes, yes. We have Windows and Turbo C.
Windows and Turbo C?
Yes, sir.
Oh.
And in the the university syllabus changes after 4-5 years. Last year, I mean, previous syllabus we had Unix and C because of the open source. Now, but during this semester, I mean, this syllabus we don't have Unix for the first year. Means they don't tell specifically anything about the operating system you are supposed to use. Maybe people are used to Windows we are using. But I think we'll make it.
But you have no problem in using Linux.
But I'm not the one who is doing that, will be doing that. So there will be 30 people involved in that.
No, no, no. But you can always have a dual boot on it.
Yeah, yes, we can have. We can have.
Sure.
Yes.
And
yes.
You would have one Linux server at least in the whole environment.
Yes, 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 yes.
Right. So we can use that Linux server as an NFS mount. And we can have a dual boot so that people can use a common environment.
Okay.
What I was curious to know is that, see, I was talking about, I was telling Vidya that if she could have, she could create 3 remote centers effectively out of her university. One in which she herself teaches,
sir,
and the other 2 in which 2 other people are there. So I was suggesting to her that she herself should also work as a
coordinator
for all the 3 and they should have this.
Yes, sir.
Is it now possible, because you mentioned you have a 100% seminar hall.
Yes, sir.
Is it possible for you to sort of cajole 2 of your colleagues, okay, to join you,
sir,
and create 3 centers logically in the same physical center?
Yes, sir.
So that you can cater to 90 teachers,
sir,
from the engineering colleges in the city.
Hmm.
90 teachers can attend the classes there. All that we'll need is 3 labs for 30 teachers each.
Yes, sir.
And each of the 3 coordinators handling the lab session. So that way we can have a multiplier effect.
Yes, sir.
Because I was planning only on assuming that every college will have 1 teacher. But I am seeing now that every college has 8 to 10 teachers teaching this course. And
so
that means the numbers are too huge actually.
It is the one request from my side.
Huh.
When I gone through the first letter we have given to the coordinators,
huh,
since it was mentioned 1 coordinator from each college,
huh,
so I came. But when I see the registrations, there are many people. Then when I came, I was feeling that many people could have come and they are not able to get this information.
Yes.
Because since we will be coordinating, since there will be so many colleges coming and many work is involved, it is not one man show. So I request you so that you can tell our institution, we can get more helping hands,
yes,
for that.
Yes.
Yes. Please, this is a request from my side to you.
Yeah, agree. What, yes, we'll do is the same budgeting that we have,
sir,
we will treat your college as 3 centers.
Yes, sir.
And instead of paying you 2 lakh rupees, we'll pay you 6 lakh rupees. Run the program for 90 or 100 teachers. As simple,
yes,
as that. Because, see, with all said and done, whatever we do, when the teachers come to your college or his college or other college, different teachers will acquire different benefits from the whole thing.
Right.
Depends on the individual incentive. Like our students only, you know. See, teachers also means we were all students sometime. So when we attend this, so we don't know to what extent people will benefit. So if we have more people, and if we say the same percentage benefits maximum, then the number of people benefiting will go
increase. Yes. Okay, thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.